And what are you seeing after the death of Noynoy Aquino? I mean, immediately after, there was collective grief, an overpouring of appreciation in social media. What are you seeing that has changed or that has opened?
Well, that the lies are now being subjected to the truth. Let's put it that way. And that's a good thing. Because precisely, the lies have been repeated over and over again, and therefore it has affected the perception of our countrymen. But now, with his death, people are now sharing the truth. People are now looking at him with different lenses. It does not matter for us. What matters is the truth. And that's what's important here.
Mm-mm. And how will this affect, politically speaking, moving forward, the Liberal Party? I mean, we know that the Aquinos, they're symbolic to the Liberal Party. They are the Liberal Party in a way. Taya Yellow Ribbon comes from the death of former Senator Ninoy Aquino, and it's a part of the story of the Liberal Party itself. What happens now, Senator Kiko?
Well, first, I think, just to clarify, I think it would be President Aquino who would first say that no, the Liberal Party is not the Aquinos, you know, that the Liberal Party, ang boss niya nga ay ang taong bayan. And so the Liberal Party really should be, and which we have been pushing, should be a party that represents, you know, the ordinary folk. And that's what we've been trying to do. But how does this affect us? I will go back to what would he have wanted as our chairman emeritus. He would have wanted, siguro if he's, you know, sasabihin niya sa amin, wag niyo akong pagkaabala. You know, don't waste your time on me. Diba? Don't grieve. Diba? What we have, a democracy, a fragile democracy that needs to be defended. We have a fragile democracy that we need to protect and preserve. And that's what we should be focused on. I think, I don't want to think that I know, no? But I am almost certain that was, he would agree with me if I put it that way. This is what he would have wanted. You know, it's not about him. It's about our fragile democracy. His father died fighting for democracy. President Cory, his mother, you know, protected, defended, under threat of so many coups, the fragile democracy. He made democracy real up to a certain extent, and gave it the economic vibrancy because of democracy. So I'm sure that was with his death. It's not about the Liberal Party per se, but not about him. It's about how do we now continue the struggle to preserve our fragile democracy.
When former President Cory Aquino died, there was a clamor. And in a way, it raised Noynoy Aquino to run for the presidency. It was an emotional attachment of the Filipino people.
Because he had no plans, yeah.
He had no plans. And he was, in fact, one would say forced, right?
Yeah.
That was the running joke before that. He really didn't want to.
You know, there's a kwento dyan. Alam mo ba yan? Very quickly lang, ha?
Uh-oh.
Yung kwento dyan, urban legend na ata, no? Because he was interviewed after saying what made him decide. And one incident daw was when he left the coaster, going to Manila Memorial to bury Tita Cory, when he left the coaster started marching with the people because people, you know, the crowds, he wanted to just smoke a cigarette.
Mm-hmm.
Pero dinumog kasi siya. Dinumog siya ng tao at sabi ng tao, tumakbo ka na, kailangan ka namin.
Mm-hmm.
So sabi ko nga, be careful if you want to smoke a cigarette, you might end up being president.
That's a good anecdote. And okay, coming from that, do you now believe the Aquino? I mean, Bam is, of course, different from this because he was already a senator. And do you believe then the Aquino trail in terms of running for the highest office in the land is over?
Well, they would be the first to say that. I'd like to think the Aquino family would be the first. In fact, that's what the first thing that one of the first public statements of Pinoy when he was being asked to run in 2010 was saying, kami na naman. Bakit kami na naman? But we've had, you know, and really, in fairness to the Aquino family, they suffered, you know, so much from, you know, the assassination of the father and then the coup d'etats and the threats to the life and all the pillaring of President Cory. So yeah, I think today it would not be any different, di ba? Sasabihin na naman nila, kami na naman, di ba? Or, you know, it has to be the country, not just families.
So you're quite objective in this because I interviewed you last week or 2 weeks ago, and you said whatever, however they define it or describe it, Sara Running is a political dynasty, and here you are, even if you are head of the Liberal Party, you're saying technically it shouldn't be about the family. Parang when he was being asked to run, he said, kami na naman. And would you want to see another Aquino sibling run after this? Or you yourself, Senator, would feel tama na?
Hindi naman. Sa akin, you know, it's really, I'm not to say who should or shouldn't run. Mm. In the end, that should be the citizen's call. You know? But I am just saying that they themselves would rather have it otherwise. At least that's what I think. No?
Yeah.
Which is, I think, critical and crucial to understand really the Aquino legacy. He never wanted to be president, you know, number one. Number two, he never wants to call attention to himself. It was never about, you know, he was always humble, always simple, di ba? Ayaw niyang magbuhat ng sariling bangko. Ayaw niyang pinagkakaabalahan siya. Very selfless. It's very selfless.
And I'm curious.
That should be how we should look at all of this in terms of Aquino, the family. You know, it was the selflessness rather than whether they should run again or not. If BAMP decides to run again, of course I will support him. But that's another thing altogether in terms of legacy.
Yeah, I was going to say Senator BAM Aquino is another thing simply because he's not immediate family. And to be fair, he was already a senator, right? So in a way, he is like many other candidates, just running again for the Senate. But let me move it closer to home. Would the Liberal Party consider, I mean, clearly the death, some say, have sparked or may reignite a new fire in the Liberal Party. Would you consider, for example, asking Chris Aquino to run?
You know, that is their decision. I will leave it to them. And knowing the Aquino family, I could be wrong, but, asking them rather than them making the decision, they would prefer that you leave them be and let them decide. So I will respect the family's wishes. It's, of course, now is the time to grieve also, and now is the time to remember the Aquino legacy rather than go into, you know, what will happen in 2022. There's a time for that too.
But then is there an impact, the death of former President Aquino? He opened the door for VP Leni Robredo to actually enter politics, and she said that. Will his death have an impact on her decision to run or not to run for 2022? Essentially, there's also the burden of continuing the legacy founded not by, I'm not saying because they're the Aquinos, but essentially how they played in history coming from a dictatorship, right? Democracy. The fight for democracy. So there is that burden.
We will see. We will see. We have not really discussed this, and we have not, because now is the time to grieve. Like I said, we will have a time for that. But today, we honor the man, isang mabuting tao, di ba? Maraming natulungan. Today we honor his sacrifice, his selflessness, his simplicity, diba? His leadership.
My last question with you is, what will you miss most about him, and what are you most grateful for with former President Aquino, with you personally? I mean, you served with him, not just as the head of the party, but you were also head of his food security. You were quite involved and you were good friends. So what would you miss most about him and what are you most grateful for?
You know, yung kanyang simplicity, yung kanyang pagiging totoong tao, you know, and yung walang kaere-ere. Sabi ko nga, sa limang, anim na taon niyang pagiging presidente, yung tatlong regalo ko ata siya sa panahon ng birthday niya, mamunluk, siopaw at siomay. Kasi mahilig siya sa siomay. Ang gusto niya yung siomay ng mamunluk. So, napakasimple, walang kaere. And then he was very, very generous with his time, especially with my children. Mm. Miguel visited the Senate, the Malacañan, sat on his chair. He gave him chocolates, no? And then we had photos taken. Miel interviewed President Aquino after he stepped down from office for her school project. Frankie, too, in sixth grade, interviewed when he was president in 2012. Mm. He was so generous with his time. Maybe because, I don't know, maybe because he had no children of his own that he was very happy to accommodate other children. And last night, we were just talking with Frankie and Miel and Miguel about him. And we were reminiscing about how really he took that time out to really show appreciation and focus and attention on the children. And of course, just hearing his voice, you know, with all these memes and all this video, you know, you miss the guy because he really gave so much and their family, and he sacrificed so much for what I believe to be the right things for our country.
All right. On that note, Senator Kiko Pangilinan, I want to thank you so much, sir, for joining us this morning. Is there any announcement you'd like to make just very quickly? I mean, I know there's a schedule in Ateneo. We've already made that announcement, but is there anything you'd like to add?
No, that's pretty much it. It will be in the Ateneo later. And then on Saturday, yes, correct. On Saturday will be the final inurnment in Manila Memorial. So there. Thank you. Thank you for this opportunity. And again, just in parting, I think what the president would want us to do today and probably reflect upon with his death is how do we defend, preserve, and our democracy, strengthen our democracy. And rather than pagtuunan siya ng pansin, siguro ang sasabihin niya, anong gagawin natin para palakasin pa at protektahan at ma-preserve ang ating demokrasya.
All right. On that note, Senator Kiko Pangilinan, thank you, sir. God bless you and you stay strong. Thank you.
Thank you. Maraming salamat at magandang araw sa kanilang lahat.